Devarim Tisha B'Av. Tisha B'Av is the black, bleak day of Jewish history, the destruction of both of our temples. And we must still mourn that destruction, because the Holy Temple has not yet arisen. And what are we really crying about in terms of our mourning for the Holy Temple? I don't believe it's for the sacrifices, although as a Kohen, I certainly would like to witness what the sacrifices look like. I imagine in most instances, especially if I speak about the peace offering, it was like family barbecues, mungalim, as we would say in Israel. And each family, an extended family together, making a barbecue, and the Levites would walk around and sing their beautiful songs, and the Kohanim would walk around and give magnificent Divrei Torah. And my view of the sacrifices would be beautiful family celebrations. However, although it's certainly true that we don't have the temple, and whether all the most important aspect of the temple was not the celebrations, and certainly was not the sacrificial rite, especially since Rav Avram Yitzchak Kohen Cook suggests that in the third temple there will not be animal sacrifices. Orval Hashem Minchat Yehuda. What will be sweet to God will be the meal offering of Judea. It will be dairy. It will be grain. Because, explains Rav Kook magnificently, in the days of the Messiah, lo yareu v'lo yashchitu b'chol har kodshi, there will be no evil or destruction in my entire holy mountain. So there will not be animal sacrifices. That's not what we're crying for. But we are weeping for a holy temple when all the nations will come forth to learn the Torah from Zion and the Word of God from Jerusalem, the Word of morality and peace, where nation will not lift up sword against nation and humankind will not learn war anymore. So that's what we're truly praying for. A temple which will be a fount of peace for the entire world. But it's critical that while we mourn and mourn with broken hearts, at the same time we are living in a period of tremendous rebirth. We're seeing the return of the Jewish exiles from all four corners of the earth, the lost tribes of Manasseh from India and Dan from Ethiopia. And we really are not bitten by despair, because we are seeing the beginning of the redemption. And therefore, I would argue that to say the prayer of Nachem on Mincha, on Tisha B'Av, the way it's been said for almost 2,000 years, is not appropriate. There's a beautiful passage in the Talmud in Yuma Samachtet that God does not want to hear lies in our prayers. He wants us to tell Him the truth. And when we say Nachem Hashem Elokeinu Tavelei Tzion V'Tavelei Yerushalayim, give comfort, Lord our God, to the mourners of Zion and the mourners of Jerusalem, the city which is mourning and which is destroyed and which is shamed and which is desolate, the city that was swallowed by the legions of the Romans that the idolaters inherited. That's not Jerusalem today. Jerusalem is great places of Torah, has great synagogues. Jerusalem has the Kotel HaMaravi. Jerusalem is a beautiful city filled with young and old Jewish men and Jewish women. Jerusalem is in a state of rebirth. What is desolate is the Temple Mount where the Holy Temple stood. And that's really what we are praying for. And therefore, what I would suggest is a very simple word change. Instead of talking about the city, talk about the mountain, Mount Zion. The mountain which is desolate, that has mosques but no synagogue. And I'm not advocating destroying the mosques, but I am advocating the building of a synagogue. And the mountain is desolate and was swallowed up by the legions of our enemies. And all it takes is one word change from ear to har, from city to mountain, and the various descriptions to be changed from feminine to masculine. Ve'et ha-har ha-avel v'ha-charev. Habazui vahashomeim. It's the city which is mourning and destroyed, shamed and desolate. And when we say mountain and not city, then we are getting to the truth of it. If we still mourn from the city, for the city, when so much has happened in Jerusalem, I'm afraid that God will look down, not really appreciate our prayers, because he'll believe that we have not been grateful enough for the wonderful things he has given us. Shabbat Shalom and easy fast.